Hello friends, welcome to yet another episode of Stand for AS videos. We have already seen how ankylosing spondylitis causes pelvic pain, foot and ankle pain. Today, let's have a look at how it causes chest pain and how to differentiate this chest pain from other causes of chest pain. Let's have a look. Ankylosing spondylitis causes chest pain by two mechanisms. One, synovitis, which is inflammation of the joints, and second, enthesitis, which is inflammation at areas where a muscle, ligament or tendon attaches itself to a bone. The joints that are involved in the chest because of ankylosing spondylitis include the sternocostal joint, that is the joint between the collarbone and the breastbone. The joint inflammation here is generally easily visible in this area as the joint is quite superficial and it is quite tender to touch as well. Secondly, the inflammation can also involve the joints that the ribs make with the sternum or the breastbone. The pain would be felt on both sides of the breastbone. This may not be easily visible because of the muscles around, but touch here or pressure here would elicit a lot of pain. There are other areas in which there is pain because of ankylosing spondylitis because of enthesitis. This includes the rib cage area. In the rib cage area, the intercostal muscles attach themselves to the ribs. The place where they get attached to the bone, the ribs, is inflamed because of enthesitis, because of ankylosing spondylitis. So pain would either be in the front of the ribcage, the side, or the back side of the ribcage. This is the type of pain which worsens when one takes a deep breath, coughs, or sneezes. There is also one more site of enthesitic pain in the chest, which is at the site where the diaphragm attaches itself to the lower ribs. As you can see, this area, this is where the diaphragm attaches itself to the lower ribs. This again worsens when one takes a deep breath, coughs or sneezes. This pain and the ribcage pain is something that mimics cardiac pain many times. How one can differentiate between cardiac pain and this pain? Ankylosing spondylitis, the enthesitis being an inflammation, would be quite painful to touch. So any pressure on the ribcage area or the lower ribcage where diaphragm gets attached would be quite painful, which is generally not the case in cardiac type of pains. Secondly, deep breath, cough, sneezes generally increases ankylosing spondylitis pain, whereas it would not be so painful in cardiac pain. However, this is not a definitive guide and you must be seeing your rheumatologist or a physician or a cardiologist to get the exact cause of pain. I'm sure this must have been useful to many of you. Thanks for joining in. Let's meet with another video next week. Till then, take care.